Hey, what's up guys, this is KDCloudy. Welcome to the first video of 2025, and this is a very exciting year. Lots of new movies coming in, lots of new theaters to explore, but for this video let's take a break from all that because I want to talk about something different, which is spatial video recording on the new iPhone. Well, long time viewers of this channel will remember that anytime there is a new AV tech on a new Apple product, whether it was Dolby Vision recording on the iPhone 12 or 4K HDR on a Mac or spatial audio on your AirPods and Apple Music, I've explored them all and I was very excited to check out the spatial video recording capabilities on my new iPhone 16 Pro, which has this very nice attachment on it courtesy of Nomad Cases. It's a magnetic leather attachment which just clips on right in thanks to MagSafe. And I've used Nomad cases in the past and they were very kind enough to send out a few cases for me to check out, and they've sent their OG leather cases as well as this new sport case. I can vouch for the quality of these products because I have personally used the iPhone 12's Nomad leather case for the longest time and they age very, very well. So yeah, there's a very premium, and since Apple doesn't make a leather case of their own, this is the next best option, so definitely check them out. But yeah, the reason why I'm making a video on such a niche topic like spatial video is because I am an avid enjoyer of 3D movies, whether it's in the cinema or right now at the home thanks to my AR glasses. I really enjoy 3D, I appreciate it, and I'm learning more about it thanks to researching for this video. So I think I have a better idea of how Apple is not just using spatial video as a marketing gimmick and just to promote their Apple Vision Pro, which is a very expensive VR headset, but also they have done a lot of things around it and how they might have just revived 3D. Okay, now what's spatial video? Essentially, it is 3D video. It's the same concept as the 3D you watch in cinemas. And the way the whole 3D stereoscopic illusion works is by providing a unique image for your left eye and your right eye. So a 3D video will have two views, the left and the right. And the challenge to be solved is, how do you do that? How do you transport the left image and the right image at the same time? What kind of hardware do you use? What kind of software do you use? How do you package it? That's, you know, the whole deal with 3D video, and every solution has a different approach to it. Now, the most basic, most OG, and the most iconic way to experience stereoscopic 3D is these red and cyan glasses, which, I mean, you can pick this up for like a couple of hundred rupees or like 10 bucks on Amazon, and they just basically work. You don't need any extra hardware. All you need is that your 3D video, your left and the right views should be superimposed, and the differences between the two images should be either in red or cyan, and the glasses do the trick and your brain perceives 3D. But the problem here is that colors go for a toss. You basically cannot perceive color. But as we came into the mid 2000s, 3D media was becoming a big thing thanks to James Cameron and this new wave of 3D cinema. Cinema projectors for theaters were becoming 3D equipped. But what if you missed watching Avatar in 3D in theaters and wanted to experience it at home? Simple solution: Blu-ray 3D, which I have it right here. So a bunch of consumer tech companies got along, they formed a consortium, and they invented the Blu-ray 3D standard, they invented 3D TVs. And Blu-ray 3D was kind of amazing because they invented a brand new compression system called MVC 3D. And the way it worked was that you could store two views of the entire movie, I mean twice as much data, onto a single disc, which is pretty amazing. But it never really took off because, you know, you couldn't rip them and play them anywhere. You couldn't play these on 2D TVs. You needed a 3D Blu-ray player, and it was this whole thing, and it never really took off. But with the fall of 3D TVs, 3D media consumption actually didn't die. In fact, it actually grew in prominence with virtual reality. But most VR headsets did not support MVC 3D files. Instead, they opted for supporting something called SBS, or side-by-side or over and under type 3D files. In this type of 3D format, the left and the right views are actually squished and just placed side-by-side in the single video stream. And it's universally supported. It's supported in broadcast TV. It's supported by most 3D TVs earlier in the era. And it's also supported by YouTube, the platform you're watching right now. So side-by-side video essentially became this universally accepted 3D standard, because it didn't cost anything to implement. You don't have to pay royalties. You don't need additional hardware. You need additional hardware to view it, but you don't need additional decoders. And it was just perfect, except that it can only deliver half the resolution of 1080p. So it's not even as good as MVC3D. MVC3D, while it was very good, it could do 1080p 3D per eye. So yeah, that was the state of 3D. Until Apple came in and unveiled the Apple Vision Pro for $3,500 and this new standard called Spatial Video. Now, here's the most interesting thing about Apple's Spatial Video. The underlying technology is called MVHEVC, which sounds very similar to the MVC 3D of 3D Blu-rays, because these two use the exact same technology of frame packing, which makes for very efficient compression and super awesome file sizes. Apple Spatial Video has support for up to 4K per eye, which is amazing. This is something you only find in cinemas. Blu-ray 3D could only support 1080p HD per eye. It couldn't do 4K. On top of that, it can do 10-bit video support, which unlocks things like HDR and Dolby Vision, which is amazing. And this thing alone is, I think, the biggest revolution in the stereoscopic 3D space since Blu-ray 3D. Now, me being the nerd that I am, this MVHEVC format was enough of a reason for me to not buy the iPhone 16 Pro, but be excited enough about it and make this video. So enough nerd talk. I think we should go ahead and review some samples of how it's like to record some 3D video on the iPhone 16 Pro. Now, Spatial Video recording is available on the iPhone 15 Pro, iPhone 16, and the iPhone 16 Pro. And with iOS 18, Spatial Video is a dedicated camera mode on the official camera app. Just switch to it, turn your phone into landscape, and you can start recording. Now, the iPhone is actually doing native 3D capture by using these two lenses over here, the ultra-wide and the wide one, as inputs for the left and the right views. The thing is, just because it's doing native 3D, just because it's using these two lenses, doesn't guarantee anything that it's going to be like the best 3D in the world. And it all comes down to depth and parallax. When something feels it's popping out of the screen, that's called negative parallax. Something which feels like it's extending beyond the screen, feels like an endless abyss or a well or an aquarium, that's positive parallax. And the Spatial Videos shot on the iPhone 16 Pro are pretty decent. Let's take the example of this picture of a chandelier over here. This has very strong negative parallax. Those pointy bits are actually like coming out of the screen. It's pretty strong. And same goes with this video of a band crew at an Indian wedding. There is very strong separation of the background and, you know, the foreground. These are the only examples where the 3D has stood out to me. The 3D mode, the Spatial Video mode, doesn't magically make everything awesome, especially if your subject is too close or if your image doesn't even have a well-defined subject. One thing I've learned is that every time you're shooting Spatial Video, your video should have a well-defined subject approximately several feet away from you, and that's when you get like a proper depth separation of the foreground and the background. And the best example of such subjects are people. And that's exactly how Apple advertised this feature. It's best for capturing everyday moments like somebody cutting a birthday cake, or you on the beach, or you traveling on the mountains. It's best for travel videos or like just capturing memories with people in them. Now, what I've understood in the past couple of months is that if you really want to do good native 3D, your distance between the two cameras has to be slightly larger, about a couple of inches or 6 centimeters. And these two cameras cannot be parallel. They have to be slightly inset. Sounds familiar? It's exactly like the human eyes. So, I mean, because of those reasons, the Spatial Video out of the iPhone 16 Pro is good, but it's nowhere near cinema quality level, which I think is a fair trade-off. And Spatial Video from my mom's iPhone 16 and my friend's iPhone 15 Pro, they look pretty much the same, so I don't think there is any massive difference between the three models. But you might be asking, how did I judge the 3D video quality of the Spatial Video from this iPhone if I don't even have the Apple Vision Pro? Well, that's thanks to my AR glasses from X-Real. These are my new piece of tech in my arsenal. These look like regular sunglasses, but these have like small tiny OLED displays built in, and this is basically like a very boiled down version of a virtual reality headset. There is a USB port over here which can directly connect to my iPhone, and I can output the MVHEVC video and convert them into side by side using an app called Spatialify, which brings me to the conclusion of this video. I think we are well into the 10 minute mark of this video and I still haven't answered the question, how is Apple reinventing 3D? Now, the first part was, of course, they helped contribute into making this new MVHEVC standard. They are actively enabling everyday users to capture and make 3D media, which was basically not possible before. When Blu-ray 3D came out, when MVC 3D was made, nobody apart from the Hollywood studios could actually author or create or encode or decode MVC 3D files. And Apple, on the other hand, is actually publishing APIs and libraries and software encoders, decoders. And because of that, you have apps like Spatialify, which can convert MVHEVC video into side-by-side or even anaglyph. You get that? I mean, I can record spatial video on this, convert it into anaglyph, and watch it using my silly red and blue glasses. That's the part which impresses me the most. And this is not it. Apple has actually included stereoscopic tools in the latest Final Cut Pro release, the software which I use to edit my own videos. And QuickTime Player has been updated to view spatial video, so with a click of a button, you can convert MVHEVC into side-by-side, plug it into your AR glasses or VR headset, and it just works. And not just that, Apple has gone ahead and made deals with content providers and Hollywood studios to provide MVHEVC versions of their 3D movies. And for the first time ever, the consumer has the option of watching 4K 3D movies at home. I think that's pretty insane. For the longest time, if you wanted to watch a 4K 3D movie, you had to go to a Dolby Cinema or an IMAX with laser theater. And now that privilege is still restricted to people with $3,500 headsets. That's not the point. The point is that it's technologically possible, and that's what makes me so excited. I just really, really don't want 3D to die again as it did with 3D TVs. I really hope that there is a resurgence with the Apple Vision Pro, and we have Android XR coming out. I hope that they choose MVHEVC instead of side-by-side, and the larger AR VR market in general. So fingers crossed, and I can just hope for the best. So yeah, that's basically it. That's my take on how Apple is kind of reviving this format. And I do plan on making one more video on this topic, which is how I am watching these 3D Blu-rays without a Blu-ray player on my X-Real AR glasses. It's going to be a very, very interesting video, but that's going to be slightly later. My next video is going to be about the Mirage IMAX in Wadala, which I am very hyped about, and that excitement is just not showing right now in front of the camera because I have been in front of this light and this camera for the past 90 minutes and I'm very exhausted. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Cheers.